In the times that we are currently living in, finding ways to be productive whilst working from home are becoming more and more important. Most of the time, we are resisting sitting around watching TV all day, going to the fridge every 5 minutes, or even just going back to sleep, just because we can. However, today, I'll be sitting with you, virtually, and being your motivation to get your work done. So welcome to the first video of my new series, Study Collab With Me. These are very much similar to Study With Me videos. I've just given it a funky name and added a little bit of a twist to it. Essentially, since we're all stuck in isolation at the moment, I was hoping that in these videos, I could be your study buddy and be that little bit of motivation you need to be productive and get your work done, whether you're doing online school, uni, or even just working from home and trying to be productive. I will do my best to upload at least one of these a week. So in that allocated time throughout the week, you can get your work done with me and yeah. But here is the best part where I want you guys to get involved and collab with me. I would love to see you guys put this video on in the background whilst you do work and we can get through our work for the day together. Share with me what you're working on that day, your study space setup, or a video of you studying on Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, using the hashtag StudyCollabWithMe. And at the beginning of each video, I will give two people a shout out. I would love to see you guys be productive and get your work done with me. So let's make the most of the current situation that we're in and use it to benefit us and our learning. So this video in particular is a real-time study with me where I didn't have any live uni lectures for that day. So I sort of just made a study plan at the beginning and then went through the work and revision that I was doing for my upcoming assessments and exams that I had after the mid-sem break.
So I've set a timer from 9:30 till 10:30 so I can finish this task. So I'm doing my physiology space repetition. So I'm sort of just going over the lecture, filling in the details of what I can remember, and then practicing recording them by typing in the answer into my Notion. So I finished this. Now I'm just going to go into my version and finish answering the questions in there. Thank you. So, I just finished those notes and also my Notion active recall answers, so now I can cross that off my to-do list. That was lecture 16. Do the next one. Lecture 15. Is about the three muscle types. So I finished on for the timer. I'm going to reset a new one just because I'm on a new activity now. So give myself 1 hour to do the next one. Start that. Get my new sheet of paper out. Muscle types. Actually open the learning objectives. Sad reacts, but whatevs. Okay. Thank you. automatic motor neuron reaches the axon panel, then it releases ACH released into neuromuscular junction and then binds to ion channels. Those are ligand gated ion channels, the nicotinic receptors. Action potential propagated down T-tubule. And then release of intracellular calcium, which stimulates muscle contraction. Action potential somatic motor neuron reaches axon terminal, ACH released into the neuromuscular junction, propagated down T-tubule, activates sarcoplasmic reticulum, and then release of intracellular calcium, which causes cross-bridge cycling. gap junction propagates polarization and T tubules activate subplasmic reticulum, release of intracellular calcium. And yeah, this is the same as skeletal muscle. Whereas in this one, the signal is from calcium and the cytosol. In relaxation, removal of calcium. Calmodulin activates these reactions, domino effect of reactions. And then there's a binding of actin, which causes cross bridges to form. So there are no submers. I should note that in relaxation, first step equals removal of calcium from cytosol. Less myosin. So it's opposite steps to contraction. Cool. There's contractile units. Now I just want to quickly try that stimuli initiation of contraction. ACH from motor neurons. Everybody sing the song. Last thing is smooth muscle units. It's the C's. Okay, first one is smooth. Single unit connected by gap junctions. That transmit electrical stimuli. Therefore, contract as a single unit, e.g. Okay, so my camera died, but I finished this summary recall sheet of this lecture, and on my timer I still have 7 minutes left, so I'm just gonna quickly empty this memory card. It's about to run out of space while I still have a bit of spare time. But I basically finished that. I condensed 5 pages of lecture notes into 2, so that was pretty good. And now I kind of refreshed my memory of the topic. This was the one I did earlier. Skeletal muscle contraction, and then this one was a lecture before. So it kind of just went over similar things to this one, but about all 3 muscle types instead of just the skeletal muscle. Cool. They're not the neatest of notes, but you know, just trying to get the info into my head. And that's what they look like. Okay, so to empty my SD cards, I kind of just put them onto this massive hard drive that I have. It's 4 terabytes, so hopefully that's enough storage, you know. Struggles. Okay, so I'm emptying this SD card so I can film more, because these real-time study things take up so much space. But should be all good. I just need... Oh, like honestly, look, this clip, that was like 1/2 hour of filming and it was literally 11 gigabytes. Like, what the heck? I don't understand. Wait. Okay. You know what? Let's just forget about that. Real time study with. Empty, please. Thank you. is says it's going to take 15 minutes, so moving on to the next thing. I'm up to lecture four. Okay, what's lecture four? Internal controls in the booty. Where is that on my textbook?
The goods.
Okay. Oops. Okay, what is this one? Drink control. Thinking yellow. Lecture 4. So it's 4 pages. Okay. Thank you. tonic contraction involves movement. Therefore, muscle shortens, load lifted. Tutorial items for both force and velocity relationship. Sick. It's actually kind of cold. I think it's raining outside. Yeah, it's raining. Okay. Why do we want to have a muscle the same length prior to each contraction? Changing muscle length prior to contraction. Thank you. Following delivery of maximal stimulation, the muscles set to optimal length will produce maximal force. That's true. Passive force begins to generate when the muscle is at resting length. True. The sarcomere is the same as no. Myosin proteins have ATPase. Yes. An ATPase is an enzyme that uses ATP energy as a source. True. Finished my prayer cards. These are based on the questions that we got asked in our practical, which we will be going over in our tutorial next week. Cool. Okay. So I'm gonna cross that off my to-do list and cross it off here. Now I'm gonna do my Anki flashcards for blood vessels. So, oops. As you can see here, I actually use, so just as I showed in my last video, I'm using Notion to keep track of all my work. So this one was the muscle pre-practical. I have my information about the prac notes and stuff in here. So like the practical info and the pre-practical stuff that I just went through. Now I'm going to do anatomy. So I've made another workspace for anat, but it's basically the same. Oops. Basically the same as the physiology one that I showed in the video. So I have the calendar and then all my course contents here. So I'm going to go through the blood vessels prac just to go over the prac pictures and the content. So I use Anki for like subjects like anatomy and histology, where there's a lot, it's a very image base in terms of like having spot practical tests. Just because Anki, I find it really good. You can use a function that I'll show you on Anki. Let me close this. So on Anki, I have a bunch of decks that I made. So this is the anatomy one that I've been working on. I have a practical test coming up next week and it's like very image based. So I've made these flashcards here. There's like over 500 in here. But basically if you take screenshots of your notes and like label them, you can do this image occlusion tool that covers the labels and you basically practice identifying and labeling different structures inside a picture. So that's really helpful for the image based test, which is exactly laid out something like this, I'm pretty sure. So for example, this would be like a dot and then you can put again easy or good. So that was good. And then it says, what is a circled organelle? That is a lysosome. And then you press the space bar and the answer comes up here. So this is the image here. And it's really good for deriving, like, because I haven't given myself a lot of information here. It really helps me to work out a way to come to the answer, like logically. So for example, I might be like, this is a stratified squamous epithelium because there's multiple layers of cells and they're like flat at the top layer. So this here is the connective tissue and this is the epithelium. So these cells at the bottom here
are at the basal, or in the basal domain. That looks like the rough endoplasmic reticulum. And the way I can tell that is because the membrane extends off and the ribosome, so I'm assuming that's the rough ER. Yep, good. What is the function of the nucleolus? So not all of them are image based, but you can add questions that help with like function. So anatomy is a lot about structure and function. So say for example, if I were to identify a structure in the image and then state either the location of it in terms of the organ and like macro anatomy on a macroscopic level. And then I can also ask function questions. So what's the function of the nucleolus? It is involved in RNA production, so the ribosomal RNA, and it's a non-membranous structure, yes, RNA production. And then in this diagram, that looks like the multivesicular bodies, MVP, yep. So this is like the villi and the nutrient exchange that occurs in the small intestine. So this here is taking blood and it's the nutrients being absorbed. So this is the waste, I'm assuming, going to the liver. Yes, and you can also press toggle masks. Like, so if you get something wrong and you want to reason why, you can toggle the masks and it'll basically clear all the boxes that were there. So you can see what the other labels are to help you reason why you might have gotten it wrong. So this here looks like bone to me, compact bone. These arrows are pointing to the lacunae, which house the osteocytes. So that should be osteocyte. Yes. Classify this connective tissue. Okay, so not all of them are labeling pictures. I've also done like classification questions and like maybe locate the tissue. So this one is dense irregular connective tissue. Yep. I just want to quickly show you. So here, this is PRAC images that I've gotten from online, because all our PRACs are online now, so they send us pictures. I've just inserted those pictures into here and drawn arrows on preview to like identify structures that should be key to this tissue. So this is bone and it's on high magnification. So my question was identify the structure pointed to and its function. So these might be questions that come up. I'm not really sure because I haven't done the test yet, but based on the revision session I had, this was similar. So this is pointing to these white things that are coming out, which are the Sharpie's fibers. And the function of those is to anchor the periosteum to the bone. Yeah, I anchor the periosteum to the compact bone. So those are different questions you can do in Anki. Going back to when you do the questions, if you say, for example, get this wrong, so this is a plasma membrane, but if I got that wrong and I pressed again, that's telling the program that I found that hard or I got it wrong. And basically it's like coded in a way that, see how it says 1 minute, less than 1 minute, 1 day and 4 days. So if you found it easy, the question won't come back up till another 4 days. But if you found it hard, it will come back up in the next minute. And that way you're repeating the content that you keep getting wrong. And it's sort of like spaced repetition encoded into the program, which is really cool. What are the three things contained in the ground substance? Yes, I spelled contained wrong, but oh well. Glycosaminoglycans, proteoglycans, and multi-adhesive glycoproteins. Yes, okay, so I'm just gonna continue doing that. If you want a video on how I actually use Anki more in depth and how I actually create the cards, then let me know in the comments and I will make that vid. I'm not actually an expert at Anki, I kind of just use the most basic function of it, but you know, it's really helpful. So I'm gonna do lecture 10. Yes, blood vessels. Oh, actually, I might have already done. Oh, I know what I wanted to do. So I could have done that.
I want to go through these slides. So I'm actually gonna play some music because I feel like these flashcards, I need some motivation. I spent like 3 hours yesterday making Spotify playlists. So now I have a bunch of playlists. Okay.
Can anyone relate?
Make me feel better about spending so much time.
But I'm going to put the music on my speakers and put it kind of far away so it's kind of not blasting in my ears, but it's like in the background.
I'm a sucker for background noise, so that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna mute this section of the video because I don't want to get copyrighted, so
yeah.
watch my music to show you. I have finished my Anki cards. I finished doing most of my Anki cards that I wanted to complete, so like all the blood vessel stuff. And I finished this lecture. So now it's currently 2:46, and according to my to-do list, I actually am running ahead of schedule. So I just finished there the Anki blood and haven't done the self-aid one, but I've finished the blood flashcards, and it's only 2:46, which I have till 4 to finish that. So I might go for a little walk outside and then come back. So I'll see you in my next clip.
Okay, I'm doing lecture 8 now. I mentioned
on my to-do list that I was probably going to go till 10, but you know, I'm feeling a bit tired and I've done a lot today, so
I probably will finish at 6 just before dinner.
So I'm going to try and get as much as I can done in the next 2 hours. So I'm doing now my 4th physiology lecture today.
This one is about skin. This one's quite long, it's 7 pages, so we'll see how long it takes to get through, but I've given myself an hour to do it.
Hopefully that's enough time.
What I just wanted to say was I finished most of my to-do list. My God, this camera is so heavy. I'm gonna stand it because it's actually so heavy. What the heck? I thought I could handle that, but no, it's too heavy. Not enough muscles for that. Okay. So what I wanted to say was I finished most of my to-do list. It's currently 6:20 and I started work at around 10 o'clock. So, 10, 12, 2, 3, 4. It's like 8 hours, which is like a school day, basically. I managed to finish 4 physiology lectures that I sort of just did active recall and did notes for. And then I did my muscle prac notes, which is for an upcoming prac exam quiz that I have. And then I also did my Anki flashcards for 3 lectures. And I'm also going to do one more active recall before dinner. I think I have about 40 minutes to do that, which should be enough time. And then the other one that I wrote down, I actually realized I already did the other day, so that should be okay. And then the last few things that I have to do, I'm just going to do tomorrow because I feel like I need my full attention on it. And I feel like if I do it after dinner, I'm not going to be focused. So I am going to leave that and let that be. And then I'm going to... After I have dinner, I'm probably just going to chill. I have a video to edit and I'm also going to just watch TV and do nothing. But because why not? These are all the notes that I wrote today. So these were like summary sheets basically of the lecture content, but I was trying to actively recall it as I was writing it because I would write it down and then answer the questions on my computer. So that's why I managed to summarize them a lot, because I sort of knew what I was writing and I didn't have to write all the stuff in between to help me understand it, basically. So I did these 4 lectures. I condensed a lot of them to 2-1 double-sided page, which some of them will end up being like 7 pages of lecture notes into 2 pages. So that's pretty good, pretty happy with that. And then, yeah, that's about it. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up, and if you want to see more of these, let me know in the comments because I can definitely film more of them. I'm in isolation, so I've got nothing better to do. Also, if you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up. And, oh yeah, subscribe to my channel if you want to. The button is down below, and you can also turn on the notification bell to be notified when I post next. That's about everything, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye!